Hello everyone and welcome to my channel, and today I am doing the Spitfire, but instead of building it I'm going to be stripping it. It's going from back from issue 93 back to issue 36 where we replace the parts. So let's make a start on doing the unbuild of the Spitfire Mark 1A. I've already took the wings off, just need to get these side panels out, then this, and then the cockpit. So I'm going to have to make sure I do not mix the screws up. I'm going to put the screws that came off the wings on the wings themselves, so I'll just start undoing these here. So I'll just put that one there for a moment so I know where they go. Set this one off here. But what I've got to do as well is the base, that's got to be done. But I'm going to put the power mod in. I'm not using the batteries because I can still do a test flight on that, so I'll probably do that off the camera. There should be another screw somewhere. There it is. Another screw here. Check that out. Set that out. So I'll put that over there with the screws two, four. So I'll get this one on done. And the other one here. I'd never thought we'd be doing this when we first got this build, started doing it, taking it apart, because Harshet made a bit of a cock up. Because to be honest, I've really missed doing this build. I've missed it. So now we need to take this off. There's four screws. So I'll get this one out first. Put it over there. Put that one behind it. This out. Put that on the side. And this one. You know, in a way, I'm glad we don't have to completely strip it all down, because that would have been a no-no. So we'll just take that out. Now then, and his screws are all in his cockpit. You know, I can't even remember. Let's see, so it's this one here. This one here. I'll take that out. Put that over there. How many screws are holding this in place? Ah, there's the other one. Right here. Move that to one side. There. Now we need to take the plug off this, which is going to be full. God, blimey! I think I'm better off taking this off first before I get the molten out. So I'll undo these here. Undo this. Look there. Undo that. Let's see if I can remember where they go or what screws go where. Okay, so I need to lift the undercarriage up. Take that out. There's all of them. There's all of them. Now, I'll be glad when we get rid of this cardboard stand. Four screws. Oops, sorry, big heads in the road. Okay. Right, this may be a lot easier to get it out like this. I'm just going to have to pause for a minute, guys, to get this off. Right, the thing is, I can't get this plug out of the motor, so it's going to have to stay in. So there's not much I can do about it. Not much I can do about it whatsoever, so I'm knackered. So what I'll do, if I can find the pieces, I'll get these put in. And again, every time I do a video, my phone buzzes. Every single time. I mean, this wire is a lot thinner than the other. So, I've just been reassured of a friend that it will not snap. So, I'm holding him to his word. Right, let's see now. Okay, so this needs to go upside down. Which way is the motor facing? That way. This facing this way. I want to get this bang on. So the metal piece goes on there, like so. Goes on there like that. Wrong way round. So that goes in there. So get the wire, put it in through there. And not facing that way. That one there, that one there, like so. So it's facing. And then I just put the back, the bottom back on. Telling us to change the plug to put an extension on. Not a chance of that with me. Won't be able to get it on. Only that, I can't even get the damn thing off. Just hope it works as it is. So that's in there, excellent. Get your screws. Put them in the holes. Just... Oh, this is going to be fun. One. Now I can line that down. Make sure the tight. But not too tight. Don't over tighten them because you could knock at the heads and the thread in the plastic. Right. There's that one. Right, so that's that in. Now we can attach this I can remember which way around it goes that way, yeah. Attach this back on here. Fix that in place. One there. One there. One there. And before I start putting the side panels back on, and that's on there, make sure that's not, because I tried getting that plug out, it's jammed, can't get out, so we don't need those there now. And now we've got two screws here, two silver screws. Shit. Oh yeah, for the cockpit. So we'll put the cockpit back on here. Now, put it in place. I think it was silver screw, I can't remember. See, I never get mixed up. Spare a minute, guys. I'm seems a bit confused again. It's okay. I've unconfused myself. But I've got a funny feeling I'm going to have two screws spare. It's usually the case with me. That's the second one. I know what them two screws are for now, just realised. Fairly on the carriage wire. So that's that in. So right, now then, this is the part I've been dreading. Get that cable into there. Right. So I need tweezers. I hate tweezers. Yeah. So what I'll do, it's screw loaded. Blimey, 20 minutes already. Bends my now like so. Then the carriage up. You know, this cardboard box stand is a waste of time. Making sure that cable is right behind that screw so it's not going to come out. Right, so I'll get the next one in. I'll just bend it. Actually, I shouldn't have put these on parts on yet until I've done this. But I'm glutton for punishment. See that so I can see. There. Get down. Bring it further in. Sure, that's in. Right. Make sure that's down there. Yes, that's something done. Thank God. And took down a bit more. There we are. So. That's that in. There's no point putting the extension lead on that because I can't get the damn thing off. So I'll just push it in there for now. And just reattach that. If I can't get anything off I leave it. There'd be no point forcing it, because I'll only break it, and then if that gets broke, that little motor or that cable, I'm done for. So it's best to leave it alone, to be honest. I mean, it's going to be fun getting off the plugs from, where's that just turning, from the circuit board in the base. That is going to be hilarious. Okay, so that's them in. Wow. Now, next thing to do, actually, I'll put these side panels on just for now. I don't remember which way to go around now. Okay, got the next one to go in here. Like so. Next one. Here. Right. And the next one for the silver, which is silver screw. Looks like this will be needing lifting to get that in there. Okay, that's that panel on. Get the next one on. That one. There's that one, and the last one for this. Here. isn't it going in? Why isn't that going in? Houston, we have a problem. The screw we took out will not go back in. That's it. There we are. So then two side panels are on now. I'm not sure about the wings yet. I don't know whether to put them on or leave them off. To do the test flight. Whew. Right. That's the unbuild, rebuild, fix. Well, I'm glad I've got that done. Wow, what a performance. Just to get all that lot off to replace a cable. Unbelievable. But it's like I said, I could not get that plug from that motor off at all. So it'll just have to stay as it is. I weren't going to force it in case I snapped it or caused some damage. It's not worth it. I just hope it still works when we go to try it. Well, I've got the base to do yet, so I'll probably do that off camera because I've got to put the power mod on. Because I've got to move the Titanic, put it back on its shelf, and then do that mod, and then we can start doing the Spitfire again from issue 93. But I'll be testing the power first, make sure everything's working. I've got to put the remote control together, and if it doesn't work, then again I've got to put all of the cables in the connectors first before it works. Forgot about that. Well, anyway, I'm not going to blabble on, as always. So if you like this video, please give it a massive thumbs up. And if you haven't already subscribed, please do so. And don't forget to hit that notification bell for future videos. So until the next time, guys, y'all stay safe, take care, and I'll see you then. Bye for now.